You do not have Mueller Hinton agar in your box? Does that mean that you cannot perform the Kirby Bauer test? Actually, it does. But instead of an actual Kirby Bauer test, you will perform a mock version of it. That way, you can still practice the skills and get a much better sense of how the real test works. You will use a TSA plate instead of Mueller Hinton agar. And instead of antibiotic discs, you will dip blank discs into any household antimicrobial chemical of your choice. Since this test is not standardized, you will not be able to tell if the bacteria are resistant or susceptible to the compounds, but you will be able to compare their relative effectiveness to each other. By the end of this activity, you will be able to prepare a bacterial lawn on TSA, perform a mock Kirby Bauer test using blank discs saturated with household chemicals, and compare the relative effectiveness of household chemicals in inhibiting bacterial growth. This activity will take at least 3 days in total. You will need a plate with bacteria. You may use any of the plates you used for previous activities that has colonies on it, such as MSAT, TSA, or BAP. You have blank discs in a small tube, forceps, household chemicals, an inoculation loop, or a needle if you're out of loops, a sterile spreader, a TSA plate, and the tube with TSB medium. On the first day, label the TSB tube with the required information. Discard some of the TSB down the sink drain. You only need about 2 to 4 milliliters of TSB. The exact amount isn't that important. The broth is sterile, so it can just go down the drain. Loosen the cap on the TSB tube. With an inoculation needle or loop, touch a bacterial colony on a plate. Be sure to touch only one colony. Inoculate the broth and replace the cap loosely to allow air exchange. Incubate the tube in the warmest part of your home. It should grow overnight. The next day, the broth should be turbid because of bacterial growth. Once you see that cloudiness in the tube, you may proceed with the next step. On the second day, label a TSA plate with the required information. Draw dots on the back of the plate. This is where the discs will go. Use at least 2 discs, but you may use all the discs if you want. Spread the dots out evenly over the back of the plate. Remove the cap from the TSB tube and pour a small amount of broth on the surface of the TSA plate. Dip the tube in dilute bleach and let it sit overnight to kill the bacteria before you discard the tube. Remove the sterile spreader from its packaging and use it to spread the broth over the entire surface of the plate to make a bacterial lawn. Be sure not to dip in too much into the medium and to cover the entire surface. Select the household chemicals that you would like to use. A student once told me that they had read that coffee had antimicrobial properties, so I wanted to try that out. I rinsed out old bottle caps to put a small amount of the chemicals I wanted to test in. With forceps, take the blank discs and dip them into the compounds you would like to test. Allow the compound to saturate the disc. Just a few seconds is usually enough. With the forceps, place a disc onto your plate right on the spot indicated with the dot. Use the tip of the forceps to press the disc gently down onto the surface of the agar. Place the remaining discs on their designated spots. Turn the plate over and incubate it in the warmest part of your home until the bacterial lawn is obvious. Usually 1 day is enough. Observe the areas around the discs. Are there inhibition zones? Compare the sizes of the inhibition zones from the different household chemicals. What conclusions can you draw regarding the relative effectiveness of the household chemicals you used? Take a picture of the plate to submit it in your lab quiz.